2011 Eastern Region Playoffs from Dew Burns Arena in Baltimore, Maryland. I'm Mellow Joe.
And this is Ida Feltersnatch. Good morning.
Good morning. We're here bright and early bringing you the first bout of the day. Today's bout is, or at least the first one today, is the Carolina All-Stars of Raleigh, North Carolina, taking on the Maine Port Authorities of Portland, Maine. And this is going to be an interesting bout.
Absolutely. You can see here on your screen, Maine doing a little stomping around. These girls are fired up. Maine showing a lot of heart right here. This bout deciding the 9th place and 10th place of the East Region today. You see one of the captains there, Punchio Guts, talking to her girls, getting them excited. I'm going to go ahead and give you a quick rundown of the roster for the Maine Port Authorities. Number 2 is May Snap. Number 4, Captain Punchio Guts. Number 8, Lady Gage. Co-captain. Number 10, the Itsy Bitsy Fighter. Number 14 is Mother Bones. Number 17, Patty O'Mean. Number 30 is Les Lemon. 43, Olive Spankins. 45 is T-Stop. 54 is Crystal Whip. 100, Lil Punisher. 273 is Spry Icicle. 305, Grim Demise. 365, Shirley B. Slammin. 510 is Rexzilla. 603, Red Redemption. 828, Kissy Kicks. 909, Triceratops. 1912 is Titanic. And 2012, A-Block.
And for Carolina, 00, Celia Fate. Number 6, Thrashly. Number 8, Deviled Legs. Number 12, MC Fight. Number 17, Miss Anthrum the Mordant. Number 23, Aris Discordia. Number 66, Daisy Rage. 75, She's a Freak. 77, Roxy Rocket. 110, Jesse King. 131, DVS. 224, Pink Slip. 273, Mora Manipulator. 299, Ginger Clobbers. 313, JoJo Gadget. 365, Erna Beaton, 454, El Camino, 506, Hot Mess Express, 999, Holly Wanna Crack Ya, and 1893, Sue You, and it looks like we're underway.
All right, the two whistles are off. Jammers are coming off the line here. Looks like Polly Wanna Crack Ya jamming out there for Carolina, getting lead jammer. Grim Demise out there for Maine.
Holly Wanna Crack Ya just quickly making her way around the track.
Grim Demise has completed her initial pass, not lead jammer, but hoping to score some points for Maine right here on this pass.
Crack Ya with 4 points so far.
Ooh, Grim fighting her way through the pack. She gets up to the front and clears it, putting points on the board for Maine. There we go, 4 points for the Port Authority.
Looks like Crack Ya is going to try and make one more pass here, pick up as many points as she can.
She's got that fanny pack of power working for her.
And she does so. It looks like she was able to pick up those points before before Maine was able to pick up any on that jam.
Yes, indeed. No points on that pass for Maine. Our ladies from Maine are out there in the white and blue. Carolina out there in black and red.
Now, Maine could have a harder time today than they've had earlier this weekend with an injury on
yes,
their roster.
Absolutely. On Friday, Maine lost to Dutchland. Yesterday, they lost to Boston, and in that bout, number 54, Crystal Whip, did break her collarbone. That was confirmed by the Maine Roller Girls.
That's terrible. You hate to see something like that, especially this late in the tournament.
Absolutely. But, you know, Sundays are always an interesting day because a lot's going on, and some girls are fatigued, some girls are injured, and that can really affect a team's performance. All right, back to the action out there. We have the Carolina jammer through. She is the jammer in the lead, but not the lead jammer.
I believe she picked up a minor track cut on that pass.
Spry Icicle out there jamming for Maine. Caught up at the front of the pack. Ooh, taking a tumble there. Still working her initial pass.
Thrashly having a rough go through the pack there.
Ooh, Spry Icicle getting knocked down by Go-Go Gadget from Carolina. Oh, and Gogo goes to the box for that. Two Carolina blockers in the box right now. Spryasil makes it through with lead jammer and calls it off. Was she able to do so before Carolina put points on the board? Yes, successful. No points on the board. Girls are lining up out there. Maine making the strategic play, taking a knee. We've seen a lot of this weekend.
Yeah, the mass proposal, as it's sometimes called.
Yes.
With all the
polygamy, if you will.
Yeah, there's a lot of different ways you can use that to your advantage. And in this case, Maine's using it to try and get the jam started immediately to keep those Carolina blockers in the box.
Didn't look like it was successful, though. Number nine. Probably want to crack it, making it through lead jammer for Carolina. But don't you fear, the Maine Port Authority jammer not that far behind her. That's Grim Demise.
Grim Demise with a look of determination as she comes around the track.
Like I said, the Port Authority's with a lot of heart coming into this bout. Scrimmaging Gotham. That was great. That was great to watch. I think the girls learned a lot from that.
Yeah, I'm sure they got a lot out of it. You can always learn a lot facing a team of that caliber. You always come out a better team.
Absolutely.
Assuming you come out injury-free, that is.
Yes. All right, out there for Maine, that's 8-2-8. That's Kissy Kicks. Kissy through the pack, but not lead jammer for Maine. No lead jammer. This is going to be a two-minute jam, ladies and gentlemen. No lead jammer to call it off.
Ginger Clobbers now on the inside, trying to make her way through this wall of Maine skaters.
Oh, hard hit and a tumble there for Ginger Clobbers. She's on the ground. It doesn't look like she's getting up, Joe.
Oh, no.
Yeah, no, she's definitely slow. She's taking herself off the track. She's holding her face. I'm not sure if she's okay over there.
Couldn't see the contact from our vantage point.
DVS now jamming for Carolina. Kissy still out there for Maine. Oh, no, and a power jam for Carolina. Kissy Kicks heading to the box to sit down for a minute.
DVS looking to take full advantage of this power jam. Picking up 5 points, five in the sky. It's a grand slam. DVS quickly making her way around the pack once again on the outside this time.
Maine trying to form a wall up front and control the pack, keeping her back. Unsuccessful in doing so far. Oop, little hit to the outside. Unfortunately, the Maine blocker went out as well. Oh, what's this we see? A major cutting.
Yep.
And DVS heading to the box for Carolina.
She accidentally cut around Itsy Bitsy Fighter there on the inside of turn, or the outside of turn one. And that's going to send her to the penalty box. And that's going to shift the power jam back into the favor of Maine.
Looks like she was able to score 2 points before getting that major. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us this morning. It's a beautiful day here in Baltimore at the DuBurns Arena.
We feel like it's early here, but for those of you joining us on the West Coast and internationally,
you must still be awake. Oh, a little tumble there for Kissy Kicks, but she's back up and at it, looking for a whip from one of her blockers, coming around that turn. Oh, almost getting knocked out, coming back in. Carolina blockers on her, Jesse King. Oh, the Port Authority blockers helping her. Oh, no, another major cutting. I hope that's not going to set the tone for the rest of the bout.
Wow, these refs are not missing anything this morning. They are well rested.
They most obviously did not go to the after party last night.
It doesn't appear that way.
I think they're seeing things I don't even see. This is amazing. Maine completely controlling the pack right there. Nice and slow, trying to hold that Carolina jammer back. Are they going to be able to do so? No way, Jose, through the inside.
DVS again. Doing some excellent work on the track so far this morning.
Absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, this Power Jam brought to you by Dr. Hauschka. It's early, but these ladies have some very fresh faces. Brought to you by Dr. Hauschka. Oh, nice hit there by Maine.
Pack getting a little spread out there and trying to avoid that out-of-play penalty. They just had to let her go. Now she's back around the track.
Oh, goodness. Maine leaving the inside open, and she takes advantage of it. DVS is through.
Yeah, you can't leave an opportunity like that with DVS on the track.
Absolutely not.
She is on fire.
Controlling the back of that pack. Can Maine keep her back? Oh, there we go. 2 minutes. That was a long 2 minutes, my friend.
Especially when you're on the receiving end of a power jam like that one. It is a very long 2 minutes.
That is not where you want to be. Early morning, late night, I don't care. Oh. Aye, aye, aye. So we got a little more roller derby polygamy going on over here.
This jam's been brought to you by Elemental Technologies. Elemental Technologies, the world's most powerful video processing solutions.
All right, no pack situation. The jammers are off. Both jammers are out there. It's a surprise.
It's been a while since we've seen a jam with two skaters jamming.
Who knew? Who knew? Maine doing a good job up front, holding back the Carolina jammer there, number 8.
Deviled legs getting some action in today.
Oh, a little jammer-on-jammer action there at the front of the pack, and Maine comes away with the lead. Grim Demise, not the lead jammer, but is the jammer in the lead right now.
Deviled Legs has such great height, got the speed skater build, and is able to pick up so much speed with very few strides.
I completely agree. You mentioned the height. She's so tall, it's about 2 strides, and she's around the track. Yeah. It's amazing.
That's got to be an advantage when you're jamming.
Absolutely. Although, if you're a short jammer, you could be weaving in and out of her legs
true.
Right there.
That's very true.
It could go either way.
Cuts down on the color when the jammer engages the
pack. All right, first whistle. We have a girl in the box for both teams here. And do not be fooled, that first whistle has been blown. The time is burning down. Looks like it might be a strategy move on Maine's part to try to get their blocker out.
Yeah, eating that time off the penalty clock there.
No pack situation. Both whistles blow and the jammers are off. Ooh, both of them getting knocked around.
Got Spry Icicle this time for Maine.
But she was not able to get through. Probably want to crack you, number nine, lead jammer for Carolina. Spry Icicle getting knocked around at the front. 2 lone Carolina girls too far out and having to let her go.
Cracky now calling off the jam, picking up 4 points.
Maine not able to put any points on the board right there. 18 minutes left. Maine with 12, Carolina 52. Maine coming into this, the 9 seed, Carolina, the 7 seed.
Carolina had a great regular season, going 14-1 and 6-0 in the region.
Not too shabby.
No, not too shabby at all.
Number 305 out there for the Port Authorities. That's Grim Demise. And Discordia for Carolina making it through the pack. Lead jammer. Grim Demise fighting her way. Ooh, getting knocked to the inside.
Discordia making that first pass look easy, but I can assure you it wasn't.
Grim Demise, ooh, on the outside and makes it through.
Both jammers now on their scoring run, but it's Discordia, who's halfway through the pack now, as the pack takes a big spill in turn one.
Discordia looking over her shoulder, seeing the Port Authority jammer Grim Demise and calling it off. No points for Maine. Carolina very successful with that, keeping Maine to that low score.
Yeah, right now what the strategy it seems like we're seeing from Carolina here is just trying to control the jam and just pick up 4 or 5 points and then call it off and just repeat that strategy, and their score will continue to ratchet up as we continue if they keep that strategy up and if it still works.
Absolutely. Roller derby fans will recognize this move. It's the nickel and dime. Get the 5 points, get the 10 points, and call it before the other team has the chance to do so. Here's the whistle. Jam time is running down. Carolina taking their time coming across that pivot line. They do have two girls in the box. I can only imagine it's a burn. There we go. Port Authorities coming out of Portland, Maine. Lead jammer, number 365. First time jamming this morning. Shirley be slamming. Change her name to Shirley be jamming.
And she's in a power jam now. This is the much-needed momentum shift that Maine needs.
Oh, around the outside, completely untouched. Shirley B. Slamming. 5 big points for Maine. This is exactly what Maine needs. Oh, and she calls it. Interesting.
Maybe she wasn't aware that she was in a power jam there.
That's possible. We've seen moves like this before where teams and skaters are unsure and they call it off. However, sometimes a jammer just knows that maybe another jammer would be doing a better job here. They pull out the heavy hitter, maybe. 305 Grim Demise has been doing some amazing jamming for Maine. Maybe that was the strategy.
Maine now taking a knee to get their jammer off the line as quickly as possible and to keep the power jam for as long as possible.
And I don't blame them.
Grim Demise making her way up around the outside. She is... No, is she?
No, almost.
Almost.
Carolina girl staying right on her, getting knocked to the inside, to the outside, to the outside again. Up to the front. Oh, there she goes. Lead jammer for Maine. Major Wood giving her the big L. Another Carolina blocker heading to the box. Uber power jam for Maine. Not a lot of Carolina girls. She's going to have to get around. This is a gift from Carolina directly to the Maine Port Authority.
It is, and you know, sometimes you see these shifts in momentum. This could be just the shot in the arm that Maine needs here.
Absolutely, a lot of heart, a lot of drive. These girls want to go up in the rank, at least stay with number 9. Great blocking there by Carolina out front. Oh, a little too far, they gotta let her go. Oh no, looks like she caught a major cutting. Heading to the box, power jam situation for Carolina, Joe.
Now Carolina with the power jam. They're gonna take full advantage of this situation.
How quickly the tables turn, my friend. Too far out front, Maine Port Authority blockers have to let her go on by.
Thrashley now with a burst of speed.
Carolina trying to goat a main skater, holding her back, controlling where the pack is. Pack very strung out. Pack is definitely rear. Oh, that was obviously a major out of play. A good 40, almost 50 feet out in front of the pack. Maine wants it, but we got to do it legal, friends.
She was just wanting to taste some blood this morning.
There you go. She makes it through again. 5 points on that last pass. That was a big pass for Carolina. Not that they needed it, but definitely holding that lead and increasing it.
El Camino picking up a major forearm, I think, there, just as that jam was ending. So she'll begin the next jam in the penalty box.
A lot of in and out of the penalty box here, Joe. And I have to wonder if it's, you know, it's early morning, it's Sunday. These girls have skated their hearts out all weekend. And I wonder if that fatigue is getting to them.
It could very well be. It's been a long weekend. Krakia out in front. She's the lead jammer. Quickly made her way through the pack.
She's still out there unopposed, at least for a couple more seconds. Grim Demise heading back onto the track behind the rest of the skaters.
Oh, Krakia picks up a back block major going to the penalty box. Now Grim Demise in a power jam.
A lot of back and forth this morning. Jammers in, jammers out of the penalty box. Grim Demise out there all alone. King and DVS trying to trip her up, and they do. She gets knocked to the inside, having to come back behind DVS. Ooh, she's juking around. up against a three-skater wall. Happened to come way back.
They just successfully recycled her big time.
Absolutely.
But look at that. It doesn't even matter. She just skates up right through the middle.
Didn't faze her whatsoever. Big 5 points for Maine. That's definitely going to help close the gap up. Let's see if she can get through a little easier this time. Oh, a complete stop. Interesting. There you go. She sees her spot, and she goes in for it.
You know, sometimes the focus on jammers is always about the speed, but the ability to stop and to stop quickly is just as important as that speed factor.
I agree. Sometimes it's better to slow it down, find your hole, and really get through there,
just like she did. Yes. Just like that.
I'm now a fortune teller. I can see the derby future. There we go. Grim Demise, another 5 points. Ooh, and out of nowhere. Only want to crack you through the pack. I don't even think Maine Saar putting points on the board. Grim Demise knocked to the inside. Polly through again. Wow.
Krakia picking up a grand slam on that one as well.
Holly wants to score some points, and she's doing so amazingly. And there we go. There is the jam. Both teams able to put quite a few points on the board there, Joe.
Oh, excuse me, I called that a grand slam for Krakia. It was only four.
Hey, four or five, when you're in the lead like that, you know, the 1 point.
Yeah, she did make her initial pass before going to the box.
We are just under 11 minutes this morning. First bout of the morning, Maine Port Authority, the 9 seed in the East versus Carolina All-Stars, the 7 seed with the lead, 40-80. Maine taking the line out front. Carolina taking their time, coming over that line. Itsy Bitsy Fighter will be jamming for the Port Authority.
Deviled Legs now jamming for the second time today. She's the lead jammer.
Oh, hard fall there and a tumble for Shirley B. Slamming. And again, poor Shirley just can't stay on her skates this morning. Oh, no. Carolina jammer heading to the box. This is a power jam for the Port Authority. Shirley B. Slamming out there, the only jammer scoring points. DVS doing a great job of booty blocking her, keeping her back. Ooh, she gets around her. Only facing one more. That's MC Fight up at the front, trying to get around her, and she does. Not lead jammer, but still happy to be scoring points for the Port Authority.
That's right. She had a rough time getting through the pack there, and now she's going to try it again, hopefully with more ease.
No, Carolina's having none of that. The pack, ooh, split up, and then it reformed in the back. Maine was able to trap a girl from Carolina, controlling where the pack is. She is through, 5 points for Maine.
She's going to try and do it one more time.
Oh, getting knocked down hard.
JoJo says no, no.
Yeah, she sure did. She made her way through the outside, up against MC Flight again. She goes for the outside. Unsuccessful. Oh, Deviled Legs out of nowhere, coming out of the box. Making it through the pack for 4 points. Not far behind her, though. That's the Port Authority jammer with 5 points.
Deviled Legs able to pick up 4 points on that one.
Good job calling it off before Maine was able to put any more points on the board. Carolina calling a team timeout.
The next jam will be brought to you by Adam Wills, the official wheel of the WFTDA.
Adam Wills, a well-known derby sponsor and supporter.
A lot of the girls here today using those Adam Wheels.
Absolutely. Also out there, you see a lot of the Rydell Skates. Rydell Skates, the proud partner and official skate of the WFTDA.
Those fresh faces.
Those are some very fresh faces, my friend. How'd they get so fresh?
Well, if I had to guess, I'd say it was probably Dr. Hauschka.
Absolutely. That's no guess. That is a fact. Dr. Hauschka bringing fresh faces to the WFTDA. Thank you again for joining us this morning. Maine Roller Derby versus Carolina. Coming up next at 11 a.m., that's going to be Dutchland taking on the bracket for 7th and 8th place right here. And that's Boston. Big bout last night. 8 p.m. bout, Boston versus London. London walking away with the win, making international fans quite happy. All right, our ladies are back out there this morning. Carolina causing the no-pack whistle to go off for the Jammers.
Off to a slow start.
Very slow. Pack hardly moving at all.
Pack moving as fast as molasses in January.
Here you have it. Oh, tumble there for Carolina. Holly want to crack you on the ground, but back up quick.
Spry Icicle on the outside. Recycled.
Both these girls still working on their initial pass. The pack really tightening it up. Oh, there you go. Holly want to crack you through. Not lead Jammer.
Spry Icicle made it through, but was quickly recycled. Lead Jammer.
Smart move of calling it before Carolina could score. Right now, Carolina at 88, Maine at 50.
Only 38 points separate these two teams. Maine is hanging in there like a hare in a biscuit.
I hate it when that happens.
It is still close enough that you can't count this Maine team out. They've got the determination.
Grim Demise out there jamming for the Port Authorities. Discordia out there for Carolina, and she has the lead. Don't you worry, Grim Demise not that far behind her.
And the pace of this jam has picked up significantly. Discordia calls it.
Ooh, but not before Maine was able to score 3 points.
That looks like this one's a wash. Both teams picking up 3 points on that jam. It's that magical fourth whistle that you have to wait for.
That's right. Just a reminder, the Jammers are scoring points until the end of that fourth whistle. That's why they go for it with all they've got. All right, the ladies are off the Dr. Hauschka Jammer line.
Shirley B. Slammin making her way through the pack for Maine, but takes a spill. Thrashley making her way through the front of the pack. She's the lead jammer.
Carolina very successful with getting that lead jammer and then a strategy move. It's very important. Oh, Major Wood showing Shirley B. Slammin that she got a major cutting. She's heading to the sin bin to sit down for a minute.
Thrashley taking a spill on the back straightaway.
Maine doing a great job of walling up right there, trying to keep her from passing through, but unfortunately she does. Great move right there at the end.
Had a nice assist from JoJo Gadget taking the whip there in turn three.
Coming back into the pack, Maine trying to wall it up up front. Ooh, successfully doing so, knocking her to the outside. Oh, referee hanging Chad sending the Carolina jammer to the box. More jammer in and out of the penalty box. Now a power jam for the Port Authorities.
This is a bout of penalties so far.
I will not be surprised if we see girls leaving this game. Shirley B. Slamin working her way through that pack now. Maine out there in the white and blue. Carolina in the black and red. Shirley B. Slamin facing a wall of hurting up there.
Trying to get around JoJo Gadget there.
Oh, knocked to the inside by King. King coming back, forcing her to come in behind the pack and repass. And again, successful to the outside.
Shirley B. Slamin was successfully recycled as Thrashley comes out of the box.
And scores 5 points for Carolina. Carolina now over the century mark, 101 to Maine's 53.
That was, I think that was a little caught Maine by surprise there.
Absolutely. I'm sure that the Maine bench there is talking about strategy, seeing what they can do to switch this up. Team time out has been called by the Maine Port Authority.
They're definitely going to talk some strategy during this timeout.
And I don't blame them. Ladies and gentlemen, this timeout brought to you by Five Stride Skate Shop, straight out of NYC. Five Stride Skate Shop, the preferred skate shop of Team USA members such as Bonnie Thunders, Deranged, Psychobabble, Susie Hot Rod, and Teflon Donna. If you need yourself some skate gear, check out Five Stride Skate Shop. Speaking of the Team USA, you know, coming up soon, Blood and Thunder Magazine will be putting on the World Cup, Roller Derby World Cup. This weekend, you have seen many Team USA skaters taking the track right here and showing exactly why they were chosen for Team USA.
That's right. We've seen a lot of those skaters in action this weekend. And Toronto, first weekend of December, will be the World Cup. Really looking forward to that.
I really hope you don't miss it. Gotham with quite a few skaters for Team USA. Donna Matrix, Susie Hot Rod, Sexy Slady, Fisticuffs, and co-captain Bonnie Thunders doing amazing jobs as always out there. I think one of the new kids on the block that we saw some amazing skating from yesterday, V Diva from Dutchland, came out of nowhere, was doing some amazing jamming. She had the speed and the strength that when she was coming through the pack, girls were just falling down left and right.
Yeah, I would expect to see a lot more from her in years to come, as she is a newer skater. I mean, she's new to roller derby in general, so we'll see her improve probably next year.
Just goes to show you don't have to be one of the old vets. If you have the skill and you have the power, you can definitely get in, you know, to roller derby and make a difference and be one of the all-stars, the superstars. Looks like the timeout has gone a little longer than a minute. Looks like it's gone to an official review. We're going to get the scoop and bring that to you. We know you're interested to find out exactly what's going on.
One of the teams may be disputing the penalty call, as we have three people in the box, two for Carolina, one for Maine.
However, in a change of pace, both teams will have a jammer out there for the start. Spry Icicle will be out there jamming for Maine, number 273. And with the fanny pack of power, that's Holly Wanakrakia jamming for Carolina. Jammers engaging in the pack there. Spry Icicle getting caught up at the front.
Oh, and Krakia's lead jammer. And the pace of the pack picks up.
Carolina down those blockers in the penalty box, but holding the front of the pack, controlling the speed, also controlling Spry Icicle, still not through her initial pass.
El Camino now getting too far ahead of the pack, out of play, has to let Spry Icicle go.
Holly Wanakrakia back in the pack, looking over her shoulder, hands in the air, calls it off before Spry Icicle can score points on her teammates. Oh, and a little wave to the crowd. Hi, how you doing? Good morning. Thanks for coming. And as you see there, she skates by the Sin City Tech Shop. That's right, Sin City Skates loves roller derby so much, they set up shops right here on the track. Last night during a bout, I saw a referee lose a wheel. He skated right over to Sin City Skates, and they took good care of him. Sin City Skates, proud WFTDA sponsor.
Deviled legs on the line for Carolina.
305 Grim Demise out there jamming for the Port Authority. Grim Demise on the inside, lead jammer for Maine. You mentioned earlier, and I will agree, you cannot leave that inside line open. A good jammer will see it and take advantage of it every time. Ooh, nice. Grim Demise knocking deviled legs out. Nothing better than a little jammer on jammer action. And she's through. Great jam right here for Maine. 5 points for the Port Authority.
Grim Demise having a great weekend and a great bout so far. Calls off the jam.
Smart move. She looked back. She saw double legs was coming with those big old legs and the two stride taking the track. Called it off. Carolina doesn't need any more points in Maine's opinion.
She'll take the 1 point. It is certainly better than none.
I completely agree.
But it's going to take more than a one-point jam for Maine to catch up to Carolina.
That's right. Now, right now in the first period, just under a minute and a half left. Carolina 105, Maine with 59.
Go ahead.
Oh, no, I was just going to let you know that Spry Icicle is out there on the Dr. Hauschka jammer line.
Discordia, her counterpart for Carolina.
These ladies are no strangers to each other. And we're working on some strategy here to release the jammer.
Charlie B. Slammin' going to the box.
Both our jammers in the pack.
Discordia picks up the lead jam.
Spry Icicle out there against the lone Carolina blocker too far and has to let her go through her initial pass.
Got a really spread out pack here. We'll see how that plays into this pass.
Maine holding the front strong. Ooh, and able to knock out the Carolina jammer. She calls it off from her knees, completely legal. And was able to do so before Maine put any points on the board. Goose eggs for both.
This next jam is brought to you by Union Vacations. Union Vacations is proud to provide the 2011 WFTDA MVP with a one-week getaway to Mexico.
I'll take it. I'll be your MVP.
Does it include a plus one?
That would be amazing. All right. It looks like the referees have called the half. Going into the half, Carolina with 108, Maine with 59. Thank you again for joining us this morning. Out here on the track, you're going to see the ladies getting ready for the next bout. Again, Dutchland out there in the orange warming up. Don't go anywhere. The second half is coming, and we have a full day of roller derby brought to you proudly by the WFTDA. Thank you for joining us. Good morning out there, viewers. You are tuned in to game 13 of the 2011 East Region WFTDA playoffs. Right now, Carolina taking on Maine Port Authority. They are fighting it out right now for 9th and 10th place of the East Region. Carolina out there in black and red, the number 7 seed. Port Authority out there in the white and blue, number 9. My name is Miss Ida Feltersnatch.
And I'm Mellow Joe, and we're happy to bring you the second half in just a few moments. First half has been pretty clean as far as penalties go. Most of the penalties have been track cuts and things of that nature. Pretty clean blocking so far, and only one official review. So it's running pretty smooth this morning.
I agree. Coming into this second half, Carolina in the lead, 108 over Maine's 59. Looks like jamming for the first jam of the second half for the Maine Port Authority. Out there in the white and blue, that's 305. Rem D. Mize. Out there for Carolina, she's wearing black and red. That's number 9, number 9, number 9. Holly, want to crack you. Grim Demise doing a little two-step back there.
Getting antsy. She's ready to skate.
That's right. Just waiting for that whistle. There's the first whistle and the second whistle. Our jammers are off.
Now she's looking for a weak spot. Looking for the weak link here. Both of these jammers.
Oh, it looks like Holly was almost successful, but not able to do so. Number 4, Punchio Guts, able to catch her up, but not for long. Holly want to crack you, lead jammer for Carolina. 305, Grim Demise through for the Port Authorities.
Grim Demise now trying to make her way through the front half of the pack. She does so and calls off the jam.
4 points, Carolina.
Carolina there demonstrating what Maine needs to do to get back in this thing, picking up 4 points and quickly calling off the jam.
I agree. This is not the kind of start that Maine needed necessarily coming into the second half.
During the first half, Carolina led 10 jams, Maine only 6. And I think that's being reflected in the score right now.
I completely agree. Number 273 out there for the jammer in white, that's Spry Icicle.
And DVS, 131. Quickly makes her way out to the front of the pack. She's the lead jammer.
Sprite Icicle taking a tumble there on the first turn, but she's back up and at him. Nice blocking there by number 66 on Carolina. That's Daisy Rage. Through her initial pass. Oh, but not before a major cutting. We've seen this all morning. Both teams, both jammers, heading to the box for major cutting penalties.
That's going to be costly. At this point, any power jam for the opposing team really going to hurt your team.
Indeed. Carolina with the lead currently. Maine really needed the power jam. Oh, able to get through that wall up at the front so successfully.
Five in the sky. It's a grand slam.
Port Authority's lining back up, hoping to try to wall it up. Oh, left the inside line open, but not all the way. Knocking DVS inside, making a recycle back. Not successful on that second time, though. DVS team captain for Carolina through grand slam.
DVS now approaching the pack.
Portland
looking for
in
the weakest
back.
Link just skates right through.
Plowing them down. Let's call it the bulldozer. Another grand slam for Carolina.
Like a wrecking ball. Tearing down that wall.
I completely agree. Out of the box, Bright Icicle. Carolina, just sees her before she enters the back of the pack. Fighting her way in the front. Carolina holding a strong wall up front. Taking a tumble there on number 313. That's Erna Beaton. Oh, still not able to get through, but DVS is successful, gets her points and calls it off. Maine scoring zero on that pass.
That was a very nice jam. And despite all their hard work, DVS picking up a lot of points there. But Maine was able to recycle her at one point, and they've done a great job with that so far, and there would be an even bigger gap in the score if we hadn't seen a lot of great teamwork from the blockers for Maine.
Hard fought for every point right there. 3:05, Grim Demise jamming for Maine. Ooh, Holly Wanakrakia there jamming for Carolina, 999, taking a tumble. She's backing Adam through, not the lead jammer.
She's got a back block on the way through. She's still going to try and pick up some points, though.
Grim Demise knocked to the inside, recycling back. Still working on that initial pass.
Oh, it looks like Crack is going to the box now. I believe she picked up another low block.
Oh, there we go. Port Authorities with the lead jammer. Grim Demise is through in a power jam situation. This is what the Port Authorities need. Let's see if they can take the full advantage of it. Oh, on the outside, she ducks around. Go-Go Gadget number 313 through for 5 points. 5 points from Maine. First time in the second half that Maine's really putting points on the board here. Carolina holding the line in the back, knocking her to the inside. Tries again. Hey, let's go for the outside. Let's juke around.
El Camino going to the box for a nasty hit, skating in the wrong direction.
Go-Go Gadget was the last line of defense for Carolina, number 313. Couldn't stop her, though. She is through. 5 points for Maine.
Grim Demise looking to shift the momentum in Maine's favor.
30 seconds left. This could be the high-scoring jam for Maine of this bout. Cutting penalty on Grim Demise, but she still gets her points. 4 points for Maine. On the outside. Oh! Almost untouched. A little twirly-roo. She's through, and she calls it.
This second half, we could see a lot of those minor penalties turn into majors.
Maine scoring 5 points on that last pass, definitely increasing the score. 24 minutes left on the clock. Carolina 145, Maine 75. Showing the crowd here in Baltimore, the Dew Burns area, and you lovely listeners at home that they're not going down without a fight. Maine fighting for that seed in the East. Number 273 out there in the white and blue, that Spry Icicle jamming for Maine.
Number 6, Thrashley. Carolina.
And she gets lead, a strung out pack.
But a Spry Icicle. Spry Icicle out in front. She's the lead jammer.
This is exactly what the main port authorities need. A couple good jams lined up, one after another, scoring some points just like that. Through the pack, 5 points for Maine.
It's a wide open hole there.
It's the way life should be, my friend. Maine cleaning up on this jam just like the last.
Look at that.
Two Carolina blockers out front. Can't keep her back. Another 5 points. 10 points currently on the board for Spry Icicle. Coming back up to the back of the pack. The inside completely untouched.
Wow.
Good morning. 5 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Spry Icicle on quite the power jam right here.
Right now, it just looks like Carolina wants to keep this one competitive. It's practically giving the points away here.
Merry Christmas to Maine. It was an uber power jam with the Carolina jammer and two blockers in the box. That definitely makes it easier when you don't have a lot of girls you got to fight with. Couple hits there. Ooh, couldn't stop her. Knocked her down, but she's still through. She still scored points. Another grand slam for Maine.
Five in the sky.
This is exactly what they need right here.
What an incredible jam from Spry Icicle.
Maine holding the pack. Carolina up at the front trying to wall it up and keep her back. Knocking her to the inside. She calls it off from her knees on the inside. She still has her points. She can't take those away. 4 points on that last pass. Maine closing that gap with ferocity. Carolina Roller Girls 145, Maine 102 over that century mark. Congratulations right there. Spry Icicle, what a great jam.
See some smiling faces on the bench there. And those smiles are protected by ProDent Mouth Guards, the first thoroughly scientific mouth guard for the Derby player. Safety first is always important in a sport like this one.
Always. Maine starting unopposed right there, but only for a second. Susie B. Slayman, ooh, taking a tumble there.
Thrashley trying to make her way up on the inside. And there she is. She's the lead jammer.
I have to imagine that Carolina wasn't happy with what they were seeing for the past couple jams, and they'd like to kind of change that strategy up a little bit.
You know, I think it might not be a bad time for Carolina to take a timeout, maybe regroup a little bit, just shake the cobwebs out after a couple rough jams, but maybe Thrashley.
Almost a sliding tackle there coming into the back of the pack.
That's
right now,
baseball slide.
Defense, if you see here, Susan B. Slamman playing defense as a jammer. That's right, she's not a blocker. She is wearing the star there and trying to keep the Carolina jammer back, maybe keep the points low, unsuccessful in doing so. Carolina jammer through, scoring points.
It's five in the sky. It's a grand slam. Looking to pick up another one here.
DVS, number 131, knocking out Shirley B. Slamming jammer for the Maine Port Authority. Caught up at the back of the pack. Pack very strung out, but it definitely looks like it's up front. Susan B. Slamming, walling it up in the back again, playing the defensive role. Interesting move here on her part.
Thrashley now trying to make her way up on the inside of turn two.
Number four, team captain Punchy O'Guts was able to hold her back for a second. Not much longer. Punchy O'Guts, number four, and Mace Nab, number two, holding that inside line. Ooh, hard hit there from number 100. That's a little Punisher. Looked like big Punisher to me. Susan B. Slamming. There we go. Through that initial pass. That was a heck of an initial pass. A 2 minute initial pass, my friends. It's interesting strategy at this point. Maine might be thinking, you know, if we're keeping the Carolina jammer back, she won't be scoring points. They weren't doing so super successfully, but, you know, it's worth a try. You know.
It's always worth a try.
It's always worth a try. Give it a whirl. <laughs> 19 minutes left in the second half here. First game of the day. Thank you for joining us. We have a lot of amazing roller derby to bring you here. 2011 East Region Playoffs.
This nightmare on 95 has been an amazing weekend.
We've seen some very amazing derby. Grim Demise jamming. Ooh, go-go gadget direction of gameplay, definitely. You can't skate backwards and hit the jammer, my friend. She's up front, she makes it through. Lead jammer for Maine, that's right. 3:05, Grim Demise, lead jammer.
Discordia now on her scoring pass. But it may be too little, too late as Grim Demise takes the inside. Now on the back straightaway. Jukes to the outside in the last couple turns.
Oh, great move there by Carolina skater number 12, MC Fight, trying to keep her back. Not able to do so. Maine calling the team timeout here. This timeout brought to you by Wicked Skatewear. You know them. You love them. B-Train and Strychnine willing to take care of whatever roller derby shenanigans you need. WickedSkateWear.com. Make sure and check them out. They will take very good care of you. All right, right there we have the Carolina Jammer for the next jam. That's number 8, Deviled Legs. Quite possibly the tallest woman in all of roller derby, talking to her teammates, trying to make sure that they hold on to that lead.
So sometimes you always want to know the story behind some of these nicknames, but Deviled Legs, it's pretty obvious with the height there.
It could be. If she was a shorter skater, I might wonder, but
right.
It's pretty obvious. These girls skating very well, very sharp this morning. A lot of tight teamwork. Very successful walls, especially on Carolina's part. There's the whistle. Team timeout is over. Girls are getting back out there and lining it up.
Number 8, Deviled Legs for Carolina.
And no stranger to that Dr. Hauschka jammer line, number 305. That's Grim Demise jamming for the Port Authorities. Deviled Legs doing a little dance out there.
She's getting antsy, ready for that whistle.
Those jammers want to get through that pack and start scoring points. Grim Demise trying to squeak by on the outside, getting lead jammer for Maine. That's right, the ladies out there in the white and blue lead jammer. Coming up on her scoring pass. Oh, sneaks on the inside. Carolina didn't even see her. 4 points for the Port Authority.
Deviled Legs on her scoring run. Let's see. Yep, she's going to call it.
Great strategy on Maine's part. Carolina not able to put points on the board. We talked about this earlier. This is the kind of game that Maine needs to play right now. Nickel and dime them to death. Take the 5 points, take the 10 points, call it off before Carolina puts the points on the board. You see Grim Demise there talking to a bench coach, talking about a little strategy. Good job there. A little congratulatory pep talk.
Maine now taking a knee.
Surely be slamming, jamming out there for Maine.
Maine taking that knee to try and eat time off the penalty clock. Meanwhile, they've built a wall. It's basically 4-on-1.
Oh, Holly, you want to crack it? Couldn't get through. Maine was successful. Surely be slamming through the pack. Lead jammer for Maine. Really great jams here for Maine in the second half. Maine has really come alive. Through the scoring pass. Gets her points, just like I said, nickel and dime. Took her 4 points, wham bam, thank you ma'am, and calls it. She's got to be happy with that pass.
Quick 4 points, that's precisely what we were talking about during the first half. That's what Maine's got to do.
Oh, she's very excited. Hugs on the Maine bench. I scored the points, hooray! That's what we like to see. All right, our skaters are back out there. Maine slowly closing that gap. Carolina still holding on to the lead, 162, but Maine now with 119. Every point counting. All right, our jammers are off the line. Spry Icicle out there jamming for the Port Authorities.
And Discordia, number 23 for Carolina.
There we go, Port Authorities with another great jam, getting lead jammer status. Very successful in the second half of obtaining that. Spry Icicle down low, coming to the back of the pack. Looking for her hole, looking for where she's going to go. Oop, tried to sneak to the outside. Not successful in doing so. Carolina holding that strong wall up front. Ooh, knocked to the outside. Nice whip there on Discordia. Through the pack for the initial pass. Oh, Spry Icicle taking a tumble to the inside, calling it off. Before Carolina was able to score points, Maine able to put 3 on the board. This seems to be their strategy here, Joe. Couple points and call it. Nothing wrong with that. 15 minutes left on the clock. You could easily close up that gap from 162 to 122.
We saw Montreal do it yesterday. You just don't expect that sort of thing sometimes, but it can happen, especially at the Eastern Regional Playoffs.
Absolutely. A win is a win, whether it's with a 30-point power jam or if it's 5 points, 5 points, 5 points. All right, more strategy, no pack situation. The jammers are off.
Deviled Legs quickly making her way through the pack.
Maine not successful with the lead jam this time. Grim Demise getting knocked to the outside there. Carolina really focusing everything they have right now on Grim Demise. Ooh, booty blocking by Coco Gadget, but she took herself out. Grim Demise on the outside, made it through. Oh, but not clean. Unfortunately, she did get that major.
Oh, we've got two jammers going to the penalty box here.
Both racing. We have the Thunderdome here. Two jammers enter, but one jammer must leave. Who's it going to be? Now, Discordia sat down first, and then she sprung. Grim Demise serving the exact same second that she did. Both jammers back out on that track. Ooh, oh, successful move almost for Maine on the inside, getting knocked down at the very last second there. And remember, viewers at home, they do not score extra points for passing them twice. It just makes it that much harder to get through that pack.
Oh, Discordia picking up a back block major, or excuse me, Deviled Legs. Picking up a back block major going to the penalty box.
Now it is a true power jam for Maine.
Power jam for real this time.
Yes, not just 1 second. Hopefully for the full minute. Grim Demise through the pack, 5 points for the Maine Port Authorities.
This power jam is brought to you by Derby Skins. Derby Skins loves making your hiney shiny.
Grim Demise coming back to the back of the pack. Maine at the back. Carolina holding that front. She's racing around the corner, and she gets by her. Another big 5 points.
Five in the sky. It's a grand slam. Let's see if she can pick up another one here. Trying to make her way up through the center of the pack. She is surrounded by a wall of black jerseys.
Carolina holding that front. And there's the end of the jam. Natural conclusion. Three more points for Grim Demise there on that pass. Maine, very successful with this strategy, Joe. They should have went with this in the beginning.
Yeah, we've not seen too many jams go the full 2 minutes so far today either.
Closing that gap. Maine now with 135. Carolina 167. They were able to put some points on the board, but not as many as Maine. That's still a good strategy. I think they'll take it.
Maine now starting this one in a power jam. This power jam is brought to you by 5 on 5 magazine, the official magazine of WFTDA. That's 5 on 5. Check them out at 5on5.com.
Time burning down on the power jam. Maine fighting their way through that pack. Spry Icicle doing her best to get around before. There she goes. Lead jammer. Maine Port Authorities. Spry Icicle coming back up to the pack. Juking around DVS. Carolina picking up the speed.
Deviled Legs making her way through.
Oh, Spry Icicle getting knocked down on the inside, calls it off. She looked back and saw Deviled Legs. She still got her points there, don't you worry. 4 points for Maine. Very successful in the second half. I'm glad to see Maine come back alive. Like I mentioned before, a lot of heart and a lot of fight this weekend, and it's definitely paying off for them here. Both jammers on the Dr. Hauschka start line. Who knew?
And we've got an official timeout.
It's officially an official timeout. This official timeout brought to you by proud roller derby sponsor Green Monster Roller Sports. That's right, Green Monster Roller Sports, also known as Heartless. Brought to you by the MRDA's very own Quadzilla. They are the proud suppliers of Antic Boots, Reckless Wheels, and Moto Bearings. They are revolutionizing the roller derby world, not just for our lady skaters, but also for the men skaters for the MRDA. GreenMonsterRollerSports.com. Make sure and check them out. Antic Boots, I've heard they're amazing.
I've heard good things.
Nothing but good things. I heard it's like putting your foot in a basket of fluffy kittens. Great skates. All right.
And the official timeout is being called to see if a penalty was served.
at this point in the game, it's very important to find out exactly what's going on. Maine, you know, a lot of people might have counted them out earlier, but at this point, scoring those points, closing that gap, it's definitely anyone's game, and I would want every penalty and every point reviewed as well.
Couldn't agree more. So it looks like
both teams do have one blocker in the box.
So all the penalties will stand. No one leaving or coming to the box. So everything's all good.
I never doubted them. You know, those referees, they're pretty smart.
Now, that you know, the skaters we're seeing this weekend are some of the best in the sport. And the same can be said for the referees and all the other officials.
Absolutely. Best of the best right here, my friend. All right. Our jammers are out there fighting their way through. No stranger to jamming for Maine. That's Grim Demise 305.
Krakia makes it through. Grim Demise still hung up at the back of the pack, but it's Krakia with the lead jam status.
You know, I always wonder what's in that fanny pack. What's in there? What does she have?
Moxie.
That's Maine.
Chocked full of it.
Maybe she borrowed it from the port authorities. She made it through. 5 points for Carolina. Oh, and it's a power jam for Carolina. Grim Demise sitting down in the box.
Oh. That's going to hurt. We're going to see that reflected in the score as Krakia picking up 10 points so far, trying to make it 15.
Squeaked by on that inside. Maine didn't even see her. Oh, taken out on the outside there. Amazing hit there by Susan B. Slammin. Up against a wall of white out front. Holly Wanna Krakia not getting through successfully. Hit after hit after hit. Maine keeps recycling. They're kind of inching away from the pack. Oh, and having to let her go.
Krakia just racking up the points. An incredible jam.
Carolina inching closer and closer to that 200 mark. Maine can't be liking what they're seeing right now.
Maine has got to figure out a way to slow Krakia down.
Grim Demise out of the box, into the pack, barely staying on her feet with these amazing hits that the Carolina blockers are delivering. Go-Go Gadget out of play, heading to the box. Grim Demise still fighting her way through that pack. Aw, a little kiss to the crowd. Holly Wanna Krakia loves her fans.
Definitely getting a warm reception after a jam like that one. What an incredible display of athleticism. That is some roller derby skill.
Racking up those points. Carolina now with 196, Maine 139. Again, good morning. Thanks for joining us, especially if you're on the West Coast. I know that you woke up nice and early, or you didn't go to sleep at all.
For those of you just joining us, the Maine Port Authorities in white, the Carolina Roller Girls in black.
Both jammers out there on the Dr. Hauschka jammer line. Slow start coming off the line. Both teams do have blockers in the box. It could be a strategic move. No pack. Jammers are off. Spry Icicle jamming for the Port Authorities. Oh, and there we go. Lead jammer for Maine. This is what Maine needs right now. Spry Icicle, lead jammer. Jamming for the first time, it looks like, this morning. 299 Ginger Clobbers for Carolina. Unsuccessful getting through that wall of white.
Ginger Clobbers normally in as a blocker, but sometimes stuck in the jammer rotation late game.
Spry Icicle through that pack. 5 points, Port Authorities. After that power jam, they do have a long way to make it up, but just under 8 minutes. I hate to say it, it's a cliche, but it's anyone's game.
It's certainly true. Certainly true.
5 points for Maine. Carolina completing their initial pass. This will be their first scoring pass. I can only imagine that Maine will look to score a couple points and call it. She gets knocked to the outside, calls it off. Ooh, Carolina won. And Maine won. It's a wash. Could be worse.
So certainly could. This next jam is brought to you by Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates is the industry pioneer in boot sizing and configuration for women's feet. Split last and narrow skates are in stock and ready to ship to you. Fast Girl Skates.
Jamming for our ladies in white and blue, that's Susan B. Slammin'. Polly want to crack you, marching on like a soldier, making her way through lead jammer for Carolina.
Maine has the right idea with the triple team. And now Carolina with a triple team of their own.
Susan B. Slammin'.
Got a track cut in there on someone.
Yep, I think it was Go-Go. Still fighting her way through on that initial pass. Carolina is scoring right now. This is going to put them over that 200 mark. Susan B. Slammin' is through. But again, she has not scored yet. Carolina now over the 200 mark. More than a 50-point difference. Maine slowing down a little bit. Holly, want to crack you a little cat and mouse action here.
Cracky now breaking through with a burst of speed.
Pack up front. Susan B. Slammin' having to come back in behind the blocker that knocked her out. Oh, monster hit there by number four, Punchy O'Guts on Holly Wanna Crack Ya. Great teamwork by both teams, really walling it up, real strong defense. Oh, Maine's a little too far out front, having to let Holly Wanna Crack Ya go on by.
Pack was a little bit spread out, but now back in it, Crack Ya looking to pick up perhaps another grand slam here.
Susie B. Slammin'. Coming back in, looks like she might have cut a major cutting, and she did. Oh no, Maine Port Authority jammer heading to the box for a minute with just 5 minutes left on the period clock and greater than a 50-point deficit. I think that Carolina might have won it right here with this jam.
Yeah, between this one and the last time we saw a Cracky jam with those incredible grand slams, I think that might be enough to seal the deal for Carolina here.
I agree. It's got to be that fanny pack. Or, you know what it could be? It could be vitamin water. Thank you to Vitamin Water, great supporter of roller derby, and supplying vitamin water to all the skaters, not just the skaters, but also the officials.
That's right. And also thanks to Honest Tea. Honest Tea was donated to the skaters and officials today. So thank you to Honest Tea as well. DBS starting off in a power jam.
Maine doing a good job of knocking her around, knocking her to the inside, but she made it through.
Narrowly dodging a track cut there. Great agility from DBS.
Ooh, uber power jam right here. Maine with two blockers and one jammer in the box. It's going to be real easy for number 131. That's DBS making it through for Carolina.
That's five in the sky, a grand slam.
The two lone Maine blockers up front going to do their best. Oh, holding that inside line. Strong. Couple of hits there. Doing their best to keep her.
A surprisingly good job for only two blockers up against DVS.
Exactly. And precious, precious seconds of time on that power jam. Anything helps.
This power jam is brought to you by Derby Supply, the best customer service in the business, period. Derby Supply.
Another 3 points on the board there for Carolina. Maine stuck at 150. 3 minutes left on the period clock.
It was almost within reach, but now it looks like Carolina just pulling away with it here in the final minutes of this bout.
Maine Port authorities have called the timeout. They're going to be hopefully talking about their strategy, seeing if there's any way to come back from this right here. Joe, would you say you're a warrior?
I would like to think so.
I'd say you could be, but you could prove it, you know.
Really? How would I do that?
Go to www.warrior-.com. It is a 5K through mud and muck. You got to climb walls. You got to jump over logs.
Wow.
That's a lot.
That sounds pretty rough.
That is pretty rough. You think being a Derby girl is rough, check out the Warrior Dash. That's www.warrior-.com. And I'll let you know from personal experience, once you complete the Warrior Dash, they give you a Viking helmet.
Really?
Yes, it's true. I have one at home.
Maybe I could fill it up with something from Flying Dog Brewery.
Oh, I bet you could.
Because I think I'd need a beer after that. Flying Dog is the official beer of the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs.
Yes, and I have seen many happy fans partaking.
Yes, we have. The crowd was getting a little rowdy by the end last night.
We have an excited crowd here this morning. Beautiful downtown Baltimore. The Dew Burns Arena. Thank you for watching this morning. Oh, a little tumble there. Carolina getting too excited. All right, and we're off. Maine starting out, trying to go for that inside. Oh, successful on the outside. Lead Jammer. That timeout paid for the Port Authority's Grim Demise. Lead Jammer.
Discordia trying to make her way through these blockers. Now they're out of play.
Look at that speed. Grim Demise getting the points. Hit it and quit it.
Grim Demise looking very graceful coming through turns 3 and 4 there.
4 points for Maine. That was successful earlier in closing the gap with Carolina scoring all those points, though, and 2 minutes on the clock. I feel it just might be out of their little Maine reach.
Yeah, Maine has had quite the season. This is their first appearance in a WFTDA tournament, so even if they finish 10th, it's their first time here.
It was an honor to be nominated, right? Right,
exactly. They did qualify in 2009 but declined the invitation. Action's underway now.
Spry Icicle out there for our newbie friends, the Maine Port Authorities.
It's number nine. Polly, want to crack you.
Spry Icicle keeping it nice and low, weaving her way through that pack, getting caught up a little bit at the front, but she is through, scoring points for the Port Authorities, 4 points for the Maine-as.
Let's see if she can break through the pack. Call it off. Is she going to call it? Yes, she is. You can see her eyes darting around the track, trying to figure out where Spry Icicle was. Very aware of what's going on the track. And it looks like we've got a team timeout for Maine.
Just over a minute left here on the clock. You know, I got to say, that is the sign of a good jammer. Really looking around, seeing where the other jammer's at. It's not just about scoring your points, but keeping the other team from scoring the points.
And as she was looking, you could tell that all the officials in the center were kind of blocking her line of vision, and it took her a second to find her there. But she did call off the jam in time.
You know, another sign of a good jammer is knowing the rules.
That's right. You got to know the rules.
And to know the rules, you really need the rules app. If you have an iPhone, an iPod, an iPad, anything that kind of starts with the I there from, you know, Mac, you can get yourself the rules app from Spinland Media. Spinland Media partnered with the WFTDA to create the rules app, and it's really neat. If you haven't seen it, you can bookmark pages. You know, if you have a question or something, you want to clear it up, you have a dispute, you know, you're out drinking with friends, and you're like, no, the rule says this. You pull out your iPhone, oh, does it? And you look
and
it up.
So much more
right
convenient
there.
Than the PDF file that you can download from WFTDA.com. Check out that app from Splendland Media.
All right, our ladies are back out there looking like this might be one of, if not the last jam of the bout here this morning.
This jam is brought to you by Merch Mama, supplying swag to the Derby Nation. MerchMama.com.
All right, there are our magical whistles, and our jammers are off. Maine is down one blocker, not just any blocker, but their pivot. Grim Demise getting caught up, not lead jammer.
Thrashley's the lead jammer for Carolina.
Thrashley hasn't been out there in the jammer role much, but when she has been, she's been very successful.
She's been pretty effective today.
Grim Demise with a cutting penalty there. Coming back on the inside, completing her initial pass. Ooh, but getting recycled there. Oh, uh-huh. No, that's gotta hurt.
Thrashley calls it. And we've got just 30 seconds left on the clock for this bout. Will someone call a timeout and give us one more jam, or will this be it? Oh, we've got a team timeout.
They certainly
Carolina.
Did. this very important team timeout brought to you by Vanilla Skates. Let the Vanilla Derby take you to success with their brand new top green leather Renegades or their straight jacket boots. I hear that they're crazy.
Yeah. Speaking of awesome things that skaters wear, have you seen the uniforms for Team USA?
I have. It's like a red, white, and blue explosion of awesomeness.
It is just a great, great uniform, and it's made by Iron Doll. Iron Doll Clothing, one-of-a-kind uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee.
All right, that team timeout wearing down. The crowd here getting really excited, really rowdy. The skaters from the next bout are lined up along the edge. The Dutchland Rollers and the Boston Massacre watching intently, rooting for both teams. Again, this is deciding the 9th and 10th place of the East Region. All right, team timeout is over. If you can hear the background noise, I mentioned it's early, but that's not stopping the fans from getting loud and getting excited here at the Dew Burns Arena.
This has been an exciting bout, an exciting weekend for both of these teams.
5 seconds till the action starts. Spry Icicle out there jamming the last jam for the Port Authority. Boat jammers fighting their way through. Oh, there we go. Port Authority's proud of this jam. Spry Icicle through the pack lead jammer. Mystery jammer out there jamming for the first time for Carolina. Spry Icicle scoring pass, and she is through. Great job, Spry Icicle. 5 points for the main Port Authority. It's the way life should be, ladies and gentlemen. And a power jam, last jam of the bout. Power jam situation for Maine. This is exactly what they need. What a way to go out. Win or lose, this is the kind of last jam you want.
It is. It's quite a way to punctuate the season for these two teams.
Oh, taking a tumble there.
Oh.
little low block action there on Carolina's part. Spry Icicle still fighting her way through. JoJo Gadget.
JoJo all over it.
She has been booty blocking the heck out of these poor Port Authority ladies.
JoJo Gadget blocker.
Exactly. You got it, my friend. Spry Icicle working on her points right here. The only jammer out there to be scoring any points. And she's through. Grand slam for Maine. 5 points. Twenty-three seconds left on the jam clock. Again, the period clock is over. This will certainly be the last jam. Spry Icicle working her way. Coming around. One last. Oh, Carolina blocker, and that's all it took. Taking her down to her knees.
Carolina's jammer out of the box to see a few more seconds of action before this one ends.
Big hugs there on the main bench. Spry Icicle very excited. Lots of hugs from Maine. They're very excited with their performance. Lots of cheers and lots of well wishes going out to number 10, Itsy Bitsy Fighter from Portland, Maine.
Wow. Not the end we were hoping to see to this one, but we wish her the best. And that's going to do it.
On a happy note, though, ladies and gentlemen, Carolina Roller Girl successful. The end of the second half, if you see here, the EMTs waiting to take off Itsy Bitsy Fighter, each of them giving handshakes and high fives.
Not the set of wheels she was expecting to skate out on, but still in good spirits there.
That's what roller derby is about, my friend. It's really about coming together and, respect and team womanship and just great job on Carolina's part. Big win, 243 over Maine's 172. Carolina walking away with 9th place, Maine with 10th.
Carolina with an incredible season, undefeated in their regular season. One loss in the regular season, but a great, great season for Carolina, only losing to Nashville before this tournament. And you have to wonder if that mental game played into their 9th place finish, having not been used to losing.
Right, exactly.
And this tournament was kind of rough for them.
Oh, I agree. And the mental game is so much of roller derby. If you come in here with a bad attitude, you're not going to win. You have to have that winner mindset. the Maine Port Authorities right now skating around, taking their lap. A really great game. Again, you can see there, number 54, Crystal Whip, with her arm in the sling. She did break her collarbone. Injuries aren't something we like to see, but unfortunately it does happen sometimes.
It is part of the game.
All right.
Dutchland's preparing to take the track. I'm Mellow Joe, by the way, and with me I've got Punchy Yo Guts and Itsy Bitsy Finder from Maine Roller Derby. And what an exciting weekend it's been for you guys. This is your first tournament, right?
Absolutely, yes.
And that's it's great to see you guys at regionals this year. The last bout was punctuated by the ankle there. What happened?
Well, I actually broke my foot at ECE this year.
So it's kind of a re-aggravation.
Injury. I expected it to happen, so lucky to be the last jam of the last bout of the tournament.
That was tough to watch, though. We always hate to see the skater go down like that. Yeah. And Punchy, some excellent blocking today.
Thank you.
That's excellent work. So what's your secret?
The secret is the four eyes, you know, two in the front, two in the back, and the love of derby.
Excellent. So, being in a tournament, with these caliber teams, what have you learned? What are you going to take back for the off season to work on?
There's so much to learn. I mean, we're constantly learning. There's nothing like losing to help you learn, and we're constantly growing and, grooming our players and, you know, there's just like little lessons here, little victories, celebrations. There's a ton. We got a long list. So a lot of work to do.
You can certainly take away a lot on a personal aspect. What did you take away from the tournament?
We've been waiting years to come here. We had an offer a couple years ago that we weren't able to accept.
Right, 2009.
So that was hard for a lot of us. Mainly Punchy and I were on the league. So this was huge for us. And coming in, whether we won, lost, we just wanted to play and be here and experience it. So I think it made our lives. It certainly made our year, for sure.
Certainly, and 10th place in the region. Not a bad place to finish.
We'll take it.
Eastern is a very tough region, so 10th place is quite an honor.
Absolutely.
So it's been great to be with you guys this morning. We got a lot of derby action coming up.